This is an automatic pressure control switch, which I will tear down in this video. It comes inside this box. I will take it out of the box, and a manual is given with it. If you are installing this controller for your water pump yourself, you may read all these instructions to learn what precautions to take while installing it. With this, we get two connections, but we will talk about these connections later when we install it. It has this reset button in the center, which is yellow. One connection is for the pump, and the other is for its main power. Underneath it, when I'm opening this cap, it has these 1-inch threads. I can see the seals in it, so I will also see what these seals are being used for. Water input will be from this side, and this side is its output. Some of its specifications are written here, let's look at them. The model number is JD03BX. The next are voltages, max amperes, and its max water pressure in bars is written here. If we want to see more of its specs, they are mentioned in its box. After that, a pressure gauge is attached here. The gauge value is written in bars. We can give this water pump up to 10 bar pressure. Now I will start opening it. First of all, I will open this gauge. I will take this gauge out from the controller. The gauge has come out of the controller. This is the hole inside the gauge to measure the input pressure in bars. There is also a hole inside the controller through which we will know the input pressure moving towards the gauge. The next thing I will open is its DB box, where we have to make the connection for the pump and the power. Let's open it and see what is inside it. I will put the screws and the gauge in one place. I will try to move it upward. These wires seem to be tightened. I will loose these wires from here. I will loose these nuts attached to the wires. I will completely loose these nuts to see what's inside it. These are the nuts to tighten the wires. These are plastic sleeves through which the wires have been grabbed. I will remove this. It will now easily come out. It is waterproof. Rubbers are mounted inside it, and when I press these rubbers, they get tightened through, and the chances of water going inside it vanishes. This is the reset switch. When I pressed the button on the top, the pin came out. We can see the reset button here. This is the reset button of this controller. I have removed the terminal connection box from the automatic pressure switch, and it has a circuit mounted inside it. After loosening these screws, see that this part of the controller has started to come up. I can see a spring is installed inside it. Now, before opening it completely, I have marked it. This marking has the advantage that when we assemble it back, then, this part of it will sit back in the same position as fitted by the company. Now before opening the last two screws, I will prop the controller against the wall. And I'm doing this so that when I open these two screws, the spring doesn't push too much outward. I have loosed the first screw slightly. I will rotate it. I will keep the force on it against the wall. I will keep loosing the screws gradually. I will not rotate it because this screw has been loosened up. I will keep loosening the screw on the other side. It is not visible to the camera. I am removing the screw. I have applied force to it so that when it opens, the spring pressure does not apply. The screws have been removed. Let's see what is the pressure of the spring inside it. The spring has no such pressure. I thought the spring was fitted into it too tightly. But it's not what I thought. But I took a precaution. I will remove it and see what things are installed inside it. A fat spring is placed inside it. And when I see it from within, a screw is attached inside it. The screw can be rotated through a flathead screwdriver. This is to increase and decrease the pressure. Plus and minus sign is made here on it. Rotating it clockwise will be in the direction of the positive, and rotating it anti-clockwise will decrease the pressure of the water. After this over here, I think this is a rubber diaphragm. Let's try to remove it. It has been water sealed from here so that water may not flow upward here. So let's open this screw and see. I will check whether it comes out or not. It is not coming out from the center. I will now try to remove the rubber from the corners. It has been displaced from its place. I will try to remove this whole thing. The rubber has finally come out. This rubber is quite strong. A plastic was placed over this rubber. The plastic and the plastic over here were joined together. I have removed the screw, so I will remove this piece out of it. This is not an ordinary plastic. This is some special plastic. Let me show what it is. It looks to me like it has a magnet in it because its circuit board has read sensors installed in it. The one is this, and the other is this one. The function of this read sensor is that if there is a magnet around it, it will turn on and normally stay off. I will also show you how to test it. Now, let's talk about why these seals are mounted inside it. It has a complete system, and this system is for the check valve. If you know about the check valve, you will also know its function. But if not, let me tell you. A pin made of plastic inside is moving up and down. It went down, and now it moved upward. When water pressure enters here, the pin will move upward with water pressure. The water will start to flow from this opening. But as soon as the pressure you set gets equal, the electronic circuit will turn off the motor. Then, the pressure will try to return back. At that moment, this pin will move down. The pin will be seated over here with the seals. This way the water will not return back. This is how the check valve works. I have removed it after desoldering it. We can see some connections here. The connection in the center is for the earthing. The point on the top is the neutral point. The point on the bottom is the phase wire. The connection of the phase will move through the relay installed in it. These points are separate here. These points will meet when its read sensor will work. When the read sensor works, this relay will turn on, and these two points can meet each other. This will make the motor to operate. If I look at the back of the circuit board, only a push button is mounted here, and the rest of the circuit has nothing else on the back. This is the read switch that I pulled out of the circuit board. I will place my hand so it could be visible. These two points inside seem to be joined. But they are not connected and are separate. I have attached the multimeter probes on both the pins of the read switch. I will now bring this magnet near the read switch. As soon as I brought the magnet near it, and there is a special point when the read switch senses the magnet, then it turns on. When I move the magnet slightly away, it turns off. The magnet works from all sides while rotating it, but when I change its position, it does not work. It has a specific point that needs to be touched. Then this switch will turn on. I will now talk about the wiring connection at the end. The wiring connections are really simple to do. 220 volts is written here. On the other side, line and neutral are written. Join the main line and neutral wires here, and the earthing wire will be connected in the center. On this terminal, the motor sign is made. If the line is upward, that line will simply be the output here. You will have to connect it with the motor line connection. And if this is neutral, so you will have to connect it with the neutral connection of the motor. The motor will start after making the connections. But you will need a contactor if you want to start a three-phase motor. This contactor will act as a single-phase motor. The connection that we were going to make with the single-phase motor, we will make those connections with the contactor. This contactor has a magnetic relay inside it. We have to pass 220 AC volts through it. It will act as a single-phase motor. When the contactor gets pressed, both these terminal joins together. You will have to put the three-phase connections on this terminal. This is how the three-phase motor can be operated easily. If you are willing to support the channel, you can buy me coffee, for that visit Patreon. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos. And subscribe. Thank you.